And finally tonight, the former iconic Nabisco factory has a new fate. The 65-year-old plant in Fairlawn that once filled the air with sweet smells will get taken down. That's not changing, but not by explosives. After intense backlash from the community, the property owner says the plans to implode the building are scrapped. Instead, the tower will be demolished, piece by piece, crumb by crumb. Ted Goldberg reports.
We're happy, we're relieved. I mean, all those things, we're very supportive, we're very thankful. All of those little attributes there, it's been a long fight.
John Mulholland was thrilled when he heard the old Nabisco plant in Fairlawn would not be destroyed by an implosion. He's lived in Iris Circle for 7 years, just a stone's throw away from the site.
They're gonna avoid what potentially could have been a high-risk situation. God forbid someone got sick. This could have been on forever. So this is, they're avoiding potential consequences.
There were a number of concerns that we heard, so we're happy that, you know, the process worked.
Fairlawn Mayor Kurt Peluso says this is just a stay of execution for the 65-year-old building. Greek Development owns the Fairlawn Maystay and has stripped most of the plant down to its bolts, but one looming section remains.
It's still gonna come down. It's, for us, it's also a safety concern. God forbid there was a fire. That would have been extremely dangerous.
The plant is located in Fairlawn, but part of its footprint extends into Glen Rock, and many Glen Rock residents could have been affected by an implosion. Mayor Kristine Morieko says sustained pressure from residents and politicians convinced Greek Development to find another way to tear down the plant.
The time lapse for getting the permitting in order, and then coupled with the residents that were showing their concerns, and we had constituent reach outs from Josh Gottheimer's office. I think all of those factors combined made them come to the realization that, you know what, in the best interest of everyone and to move forward in a productive way, they decided to go ahead and cancel the implosion.
The method of demolition is different, but the future for this site remains the same. Greek Development is planning on turning this former cookie factory into a warehousing complex. Mulholland says that brings a unique set of challenges for residents who live nearby. But he also says the circumstances are not as dire as when residents were faced with the threat of an implosion.
There's a lot of things that are happening where there is that transparency, which wasn't there before when they were planning to knock down the building. I think what's happening now is they're following the right processes and controls so that it's, they'll be a better neighbor. Is it going to be a 24/7 operation? Is there going to be lighting that's going to be higher?
My main concern is the traffic impact on our local roads. That will create a logistics burden on our main thoroughfares through our town. And we already have a traffic problem.
We do encourage any residents that want to be heard to do the same thing, to go to our planning board meetings and make sure you share your feelings on it.
According to the minutes from those planning board meetings, a spokesman for Greek Development says it's unlikely that a warehouse there would operate 24/7. But they've learned their lesson with the resistance to the implosion, so they'll host regular meetings with people who live nearby to hear concerns they might have. In Glen Rock, I'm Ted Goldberg, NJ Spotlight News.